God's will and not serve sin. And he gave you what you need on the inside of you so that you do not have to serve sin. He says, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead, it abides inside of you, inside your mortal body. That's what the scripture says, that same power. So do you realize the power that you have on the inside of you when you become born again? All we have to do is access the power of God that's on the inside of us. And that's what we don't do sometimes. We access our flesh. Hallelujah. We take advice from our flesh and we don't access the power of God that's on the inside of us. Oh, God gave you everything you need that pertains to this life. Everything that you need to live godly, he put it on the inside of you. So you already have it. Amen. Go ahead, sister. Be sure to speak loud enough because we have the Facebook group in here.
By his word.
Yes. Amen. Amen. You access the power of God through the word.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank God for the word. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but his word shall stand forever. It's life in the word of God. We don't have to be defeated Christians. That's why the grace of God is the power of the gospel, the power for you to live righteous. Amen. And it's not, you don't have to struggle. When you've given your will over to God and when you renewed your mind. Because if we put the word of God in our hearts, and we got to get in it and read it to learn it. It's not osmosis. You can't just stick it up next to your head and the knowledge is transferred. It's not osmosis. That's why you have to read the word. You have to come together and hear the word. He put the different gifts in the bodies, apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers for the perfecting of the saints. So you hear the word, you read the word, you listen to the word. Hallelujah. And that's how you walk this out. And then when situations arise, Holy Spirit will bring back to your remembrance the word of God, which gives you the power to walk it out. You wanted to say something else. I'm sorry. Okay. All right. Praise God. Praise God. So we want to, you know what? I'm just so, I'm going to use the word passionate about people knowing what you have, believers, knowing what you have on the inside of you. You have the power of God on the inside of you. He put his spirit on the inside of you. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead. We should not be defeated Christians. Glory to God. We have his Holy Spirit living on the inside of us. Glory to God. So we do not have to be defeated. It's a choice. And sometimes we don't, this in this day and time, and I don't know if I've ever seen it as much, because I've been on this earth a few years. I don't know if I've seen it as much to where as many are not taking responsibility for their own actions or for what they do. It's like somebody else's fault. If you say something to me and I go off, that's your fault. No, it's mine. Hallelujah. Because I'm the one that have control over my own self. Whatever you say, I have no control over that. But if I go off and take you out, then that's my fault. I can't say, well, I did this because, you know, and I'm not talking about somebody pulling a gun on you or something like that. That's a whole different category. But you understand what I'm saying when I say that. We always blaming other people for our actions. when it is not. That's what that says is, I have something on the inside of me that I need to get in the Word of God and get the victory over. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we want to live godly in Christ Jesus. We are dead with Christ. We are dead with Christ, but living with him, because we know he died, but we know he rose again. So we are alive in Christ. We are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And that's how we have to see ourselves. We're seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. We have to see ourselves. You know what? I'm with Christ. I see this situation happening right here. I'm not coming down from where I'm seated. I'm not coming down to the enemy's level. Glory to God. And I thought about Jesus, and Pastor had mentioned this the other day. When Satan tried to tempt Jesus, he didn't try to prove who he was. He didn't say, "Satan, do you know who I am? I am the Son of God." He didn't go there. You know what he did? Gave him the Word of God. And that's what we have to do when we get in tight situations. Yeah, you know, some situations are tight. And when we get in tight situations, because we have renewed our mind with the Word of God is going to come up, and we fight the enemy with the Word. Hallelujah. Oh, if we can get a revelation of that. We'll have so many more victories. We won't be tempted to sink down. We will be victorious. Hallelujah. And sometimes when it feels overwhelming, number one, he said, when my heart is overwhelmed, I go to the rock that's higher than I. Hallelujah. Lead me to the rock that's higher than I, when my heart is overwhelmed. And the other thing, we have brothers and sisters. Of course, make sure they're spiritual brothers and sisters that we can call and, look, I need prayer right now. Hallelujah. God didn't make us an island where we're supposed to be over somewhere by ourselves serving God. God did not make us an island. He did not make us to be by ourselves. Hallelujah. In fact, he said in his word, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. Now, we know COVID-19 is going on right now. So bar COVID-19, once all this is over, make sure that you get in a good church, get in good fellowship with other believers, because we are helpers to one another. And many times, even blessing somebody else, witnessing to somebody else, praying for somebody else, oh, it takes the attention off yourself. Glory to God. You forget about what's going on with you, and you're praying for your sister or your brother, and it just ignites what's on the inside of you. So that's a little nugget. Make sure you don't get off on an island by yourself. That's amen. Yes. Amen. Because God don't want us isolated. The only time we isolate is when we're getting along with the Lord. And you do that for a period of time, not the rest of your life. Amen. Amen. There are times that we spend time with the Lord, but we should not be isolated all the time. Really, because if you're doing that, then you can't really do the work of the Lord. Hallelujah. I may need you today. And you may have not decided, barring COVID-19, y'all understand what I'm saying? You may decide, I don't feel like doing it today. I don't feel like going today. God may have sent you on purpose to minister to somebody else. And you think about how you feel. Glory to God. Yeah, sometimes you don't feel like getting up going. Amen. I'm in that number two. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you don't, but you don't. I don't consult my flesh about what I need to do. I consult the Word of God about what I need to do. And it's funny, because once you push past that, you all good. Amen. Hallelujah. So sometimes we need to think about somebody else. Amen. It says, now if we be dead with Christ, we're in Romans 6:8-9. Romans 6, 8 through 9, it says, now if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him, knowing that Christ, being raised from the dead, dieth no more. Death hath no more dominion over him. If you don't know this, if you aren't really established in it, then you won't experience the resurrection life. Excuse me. You won't experience victory and the power that belongs to you. You won't experience resurrection life, victory, and power that belongs to you. And oh, I tell you what, it's a testimony when you have stuff going on in your life, because the Bible did tell us that in this world that we will have trouble. We're going to have trials. We're going to have tribulations. And sometimes people see what's going on with you. So you don't have to act like it ain't going on. You know what I'm saying? People see what's going on with you. But they can also see that you're walking through it with joy and with a victory. And somebody is looking at your life saying, wow, I wonder what they have. I wonder what's going on with them that they can overcome these things. I see what's happening to them. And they didn't go crazy and lose their mind. Hallelujah. They didn't go and do things that they did before they were born again. People see that. And then they will want to know, what do you have? I saw what you're going through. That's why we can't, and I can remember time I used my own self as an example when I was new, you know, being born again, just a few years in, and stuff would happen because I was under the impression, unknowingly, I was under the impression that when you get born again, you know, it's going to be all good. And when I bind the devil, he going right now, him and all, every evidence of it. That's what I thought. Now, the devil is bound when I bind him, okay? But sometimes the whatever you're praying for, it don't disappear or go away right at that moment. Hallelujah. So that's when we got to stay in faith. And I thought that's what it did. And then when it didn't, and, you know, I'm walking and I was like, it was like I was trying to take up for God. Y'all know what I'm saying when I say that? When stuff happens, it's like sometimes we try to make an excuse or create another answer for why it's happening. But you know what? That's okay. When a trial or tribulation hit you, keep walking in faith. Keep walking in victory. Keep believing the word of God. You confess the word of God. You confess his promises. And they are true. They are amen. Your prayers are answered. Amen. All we're doing is waiting on the manifestation of what we prayed for. And you know what? I don't have to take up for God. You know what I'm saying? He big enough to do that himself. But that was just a lack of knowledge. And then back then, you know, we thought, well, I can't say we, because I don't like to put everybody in the same category. Some thought, including me, that, you know, once you pray, get born again, and then if the manifestation don't come right then, oh, God, something is wrong with me. You know, when it's not, when you're walking in the word, it's not about anything being wrong with you. It's about the enemy coming after your faith. Amen. Hallelujah. When I learned the truth, glory to God. The struggle wasn't bad because I knew the truth. I didn't have to struggle with it because I knew what the truth was. I knew what the word of God says. Amen. And so if you don't know that you have been risen for victory, if you aren't really establishing the word, then you won't experience the resurrection life, victory, and power that belongs to you. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. Jesus died for that. The price has already been paid. It's almost like this is just an example. It's almost like somebody paid for you a brand new car and said all you got to do is go over on 5th Street and pick it up. Hallelujah. And you still sitting back saying, I need a car. I need a car. I need a car. I need a car. No, you have a car. All you have to do is go get it. And in order to walk in victory, all you have to do is go get the word of God, get the scriptures, and claim your victory. Claim what God has promised you. I tell you, he said all of his promises are yea and amen. Glory to God. And whatever he has promised, oh, he's able to fulfill it. All we got to do is wait on it. Amen. And we need that for the resurrection life. Most people understand that Jesus, this is B, 4B. Most people understand that Jesus isn't struggling with sin. We know that, right? Okay. For in that he died, Romans 6 and 10 says, for in that he died, he died unto sin once. But in that he liveth unto God. See, when Jesus died, he took on our sins. Amen. And then he died to that. And he was resurrected from the dead. Not going into the whole story of it. He was resurrected from the dead. So he lives. And see, you are alive unto God right now. Glory to God. And you need to see yourself dead to sin the same way that Christ is dead to sin. That's how you have to see yourself. Hallelujah. And what I wrote down, when temptation comes, you say, I'm dead to that. When something tries to present itself to you, when an old attitude tries to come up, I'm dead to that. I'm not, see, like I said before, we seated with Christ in heavenly places. And in order for you to grab what you had, you got to go backwards to get what you had. So you want to say, I'm dead to that. I'm not going back to those dead places that I was resurrected from. I'm not going back there because I'm alive to Christ. And when you have the word of God on the inside of you, Holy Spirit brings that word back to your remembrance. And then you have a choice of whether you want to believe, whether you want to walk in that truth or not. Because when he brings that truth back to you, he gives you the grace to walk it out. And sometimes, yes, it's a challenge. And you know what? It's a challenge to your flesh. That's what it is. Hallelujah. You got the victory. The victory is already yours. Hallelujah. It is already yours. So receive it. So it says in Romans 6 and 11, it says, likewise, or in the same manner, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God. And that's what I was just talking about. You're alive unto God, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Bible tells us don't put no confidence in his flesh. Hallelujah. And that's where we make the mistake sometimes. We put confidence, well, I can do it. And then we begin to walk in areas that Holy Spirit is not leading us into. Because you think you can do it? Mm-mm. Hallelujah. Will he get you out? Yeah, he get you out. You may have a couple scars coming out, but he gonna get you out. Amen. Hallelujah. So likewise, or in the same manner, reckon ye yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin. You do not have to continue in sin. And when I say that, you do not have to make sin a way of life. Will you sin? Most likely. Okay, but thank God for what? 1 John 1 and 9. Yep. And thank God for the grace. Yes, thank God for his grace. Because if you sin, he is 1 John 1:9. If you sin, It doesn't say when you sin. It says if you sin, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us. Look at this. He cleanses us from all unrighteousness. He cleanses us from the effects of that thing. Glory to God. When the effects of that thing try to come back, you have to remember that he has cleansed you from that. Because that's what the enemy will try to do. He'll try to bring the effects of that sin back to you. Amen. And many times, whoo, hallelujah. This just came. Many times some of the, how can I say this? Because we are overcomers, some of the effects of what you went through before will try to come back to you. And sometimes we work it out in the wrong ways, where we need to work it out with the Word of God. And we'll keep saying, well, this is why I do this, because this happened to me. Hallelujah. And it may be initially, but the Word of God cleanses us from all unrighteousness. So the effects of anything that has happened or that you've done wrong, the effects of that in you. Now, let me clarify that. It may be some effects that maybe some things that happened that affected other people, which you have no control over that part of it. So some of those effects may be left. But as far as the effects on you, you have to remind the devil that that is not who I am. Hallelujah. Because something will come up. Let me give you an example. I have 4 grown kids, and there are some things that I wish I had done differently. Even though, you know, I wasn't a terrible mom or anything like that. But, you know, as you get older, you realize I could have handled that a little bit differently, and then maybe that effect wouldn't have happened to them. Okay? Even though, thank God for his grace, because he'll bless them too. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes the enemy, what he'll do, he'll try to bring, just say for instance, if that kid is still acting out or whatever, and you done worked everything out and God done worked everything out, and then you see him acting up, and then the enemy, what he'll try to do, he'll try to bring back to your remembrance. You remember, if you had done this, then that probably wouldn't have happened. That probably would not be happening. Amen. And see, what he's trying to do is bring the effects of that sin back to you, okay? Because it is something I could have done differently. And he tries to bring that back to your mind for condemnation. But God cleanses us from all that, especially once you make it right. Hallelujah. When you go to your kids and I'm just using myself for an example and something that I had to do, when you go and say, you know what, I could have done this right here a little bit differently. So I apologize for that, because I was part of my parenting time, I was trying to make up for some of the things that, let me give you an example. I got pregnant at a young age, okay? And I didn't want that to happen to my girls. So I was like, what they call the mom that hover over? What, the helicopter mom? It was like, you know, and yeah, we're supposed to watch out for your kids, but you're not supposed to do all that. Okay, I became like the helicopter mom, where I was operating more in fear. You see what I'm saying? And some of that effect, I was too hard in some things. So some of that effect, when they, it came out in their lives. I mean, they doing well, but I'm just saying, initially it came out in their lives. And the enemy would try to make me feel like, well, if you had done this like this, then that would not have happened. But I had to get my mind clean through the Word, that once I make stuff right, it's done with. And I had to have a conversation. Okay, we talked about this. And, you know, I've repented. And, baby, you got to work stuff out right now on your own. Hallelujah. I don't even know who I'm saying that for, but somebody needed that. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And you know what? Parents and whoever, that whatever sin it was, what that does is releases you from the guilt of it. Because the enemy will try to bring things back to you. And that's called experiencing the resurrection life. That's called when Jesus cleanses us from all unrighteousness and every unrighteous thought. Because when those thoughts come to your mind, it is not from God. It is an unrighteous thought. And sometimes we think unrighteous thoughts is some, sex, drugs, drinks. There are other unrighteous thoughts that try to captivate our mind and get us out of the will of God. Amen. Hallelujah. And do you know my time is up? Hallelujah. I'm ending on time today. My time is up. I didn't even get as far as I thought I was going to get, but hallelujah. You know what? We're victorious. Oh my gosh. Sometimes I see believers and I want them to know so bad. Hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, you wish you could split their head open and put it inside of there. Amen. So that they'll know. Because you'll know that if they make certain adjustments. Woo! Hallelujah. That if you just do this, you'll get the victory and you won't have to struggle like that. Glory to God, but that's what we have to pray. Amen. Hallelujah. We're praying for one another. So listen, my time is up. And thank you so much for those that are on Facebook and those that are here for joining us on today. Thank you for your comments. And God bless you. And please go take a break. Do what you got to do. And join us again probably about 11:30. Join us so we can do our preliminaries. And join us again at 11:30. God bless you. Amen.